Hi friends, welcome to Margi Newspaper Simplified. In today's video, we are going to discuss about Indus Water Treaty. Recently, there was a meeting of Permanent Indus Commission in New Delhi, and in that context, Indus Water Treaty, it becomes important. In September 2020, it completed 60 years. And at that time, there was one article in The Wire titled 60 Years of Indus Water Treaty and how it survived many a fraught moment. In the 60 years, how this treaty survived. 19 September 1960, on this day, this Indus Water Treaty was signed, and then this article in September 2020. So 19 September 1960, Indus Water Treaty signed between India and Pakistan to share waters from the Indus River system. So Indus River system, entire Indus River system they are talking about. It was mediated by World Bank. This treaty was mediated by World Bank, and some minor details like Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru went to Karachi for signing this treaty. He went to Karachi, and it was then capital of Pakistan, to sign this treaty with the Pakistani head of state, General Ayub Khan. From World Bank side, Vice President of World Bank, W.A.B. Iliff, also signed this document. So some minor details related to this Indus Water Treaty. Now the major provision is about allocation, how waters were allocated. So allocation, waters from three western flowing rivers, that is Indus, Jhelum and Chenab, it was allocated to Pakistan, bearing some limited use for India. J&K, for the purpose of water, they have some limitation there, bearing some limited use for India in J&K. And then India was given entire control of waters from the other three rivers. Other three rivers, that is Ravi, Bias and Satluj. Now under this Indus Water Treaty, what is the specific provision given here? That 3.60 million acre feet of storage is allowed to India. 3.60 million acre feet of storage is allowed to India. And within that, 0.40 million acre feet is related to Indus, that much water you can store. Then 1.50 million acre feet, it is about Jhelum River, and then 1.70 million acre feet, it is about Chenab River. So when you talk about this limited use for India, then this is the data, that this much amount of water you can use. And sector wise, when you are talking about this water sharing, 2.85 million acre feet for conservation storage and an additional 0.75 million acre feet for flood storage. So this data is given in this article, that how much water we can use from these western rivers. Now despite a lot of opposition and criticism about this treaty, it still managed to survive even after three wars. Three wars they are talking, 1965, 71 and 1999, and a number of military standoffs were there. After that, political turmoils were there, but still this treaty survived. In recent years, now they are talking about some chronology. In recent years, due to some widening of supply-demand gap of water in both India and Pakistan, there has been rise in water nationalism. Now, what are important issues which are appearing here? Water nationalism, this is important keyword, water nationalism. State, civil society and militant groups, even militant groups, are raising the issues of Indus River system waters in their rallies. And when you talk about these militant groups, then March 2010, Jamaat-ud-Dawah chief Hafiz Saeed denounced India's so-called theft of waters through illegal dams. And in their rallies, they used slogans like water or war, water flows or blood. So these kind of slogans were used in the rallies. After that, growing number of multi-purpose hydropower projects, that is also a cause of tension. For example, Salar Dam, there was conflict related to the Salar Dam, 1970. And thus that issue was resolved in 1978. After that, Baglihar Dam, this issue was resolved in 2007. And even currently going on issue, Kishan Ganga Hydroelectric Project, KHEP, Kishan Ganga Hydroelectric Project. Now related to this Kishan Ganga Hydroelectric Project, Permanent Court of Arbitration, this is also part of this IWT, Indus Water Treaty mechanism. Permanent Court of Arbitration, it delivered final verdict in 2013, which was frequently opposed by Pakistan. Pakistan kept on challenging the verdict. In 2016, even they tried to stop the construction work by firing about 18 shells. 18 shells were fired in Gurez Valley, North Kashmir, by Pakistani army. And even With this opposition, in 2018, Indian Prime Minister inaugurated 3 units of KHKP despite the obstruction from Pakistan. So this was related to Kishan Ganga hydroelectric project. September 2016, after Uri attack, Indian Prime Minister said, blood and water cannot flow simultaneously. So these kind of words are being used, blood and water cannot flow simultaneously. And soon after, India suspended the annual meeting of Permanent Indus Commission. So in that year, annual meeting which regularly happened, it was suspended. March 2017, India attended the Indus Commission meeting at Islamabad. After that, 2018, Indus Commissioners held meeting in New Delhi. So alternately, they are having their meetings. And in this 2018 meeting, technical discussions were held on various hydroelectric projects like Pakal Dul, P-A-K-A-L-D-U-L, Pakal Dul, and Lower Kalnad. So these projects were discussed in 2018 meeting. February 2019, again there was Pulwama attack. And after that, Union Minister of Water Resources said that Government of India had decided to stop its share of water from eastern rivers from flowing into Pakistan. Now here the issue is, can we unilaterally exit from this treaty? Can we unilaterally exit? So Indus Water Treaty, it does not have a unilateral exit clause. So you cannot directly exit from this treaty. There is no unilateral exit clause. Even the severance of diplomatic and consular relationships between these two countries, India and Pakistan, cannot terminate this Indus Water Treaty. So it is irrelevant in any case that if diplomatic and consular relations are also severed, in that case also you cannot terminate from this Indus Water Treaty. And if even in special circumstances, if you say that we are going to get out from this treaty, in that case there are some other rules and regulations also, like even if Indus Water Treaty gets revoked in ultimate special situation, in that case also there are international conventions, rules and principles which secure the water interest of lower riparian states. So in that case again there are some limitations on this water sharing, the lower riparian states. After that also, the abrogation of Indus Water Treaty will send alarm bells ringing for India's other neighbors, like India's other lower riparian states like Bangladesh, which is having a lot of water flowing into their country from India. So if we are reacting on this Indus Water Treaty negatively, in that case it can send alarm bells ringing for some other our neighbors like Bangladesh. And then China factor is also there, that growing collaboration between Pakistan and China on water projects, it may lead Chinese to become much more assertive towards India. So that is also cause of concern. So here in conclusion, what they are saying, that instead of contemplating abrogation, that we will leave this treaty and finding faults with this treaty, we should, both countries, we should explore it for mutual benefits. And when you are talking about mutual benefits related to Indus Water Treaty, then some important articles are mentioned in this Indus Water Treaty. For example, Article 7. Article 7 of Indus Water Treaty. Future cooperation. It talks about future cooperation. It calls for taking up joint studies and engineering works on the rivers to benefit people living in this Indus River system catchment. So it can benefit both countries. Article 7 of Indus Water Treaty. Article 9 of Indus Water Treaty. It talks about mechanism to settle questions, differences and disputes over hydro infrastructure projects. Article 9. And then Article 12 of Indus Water Treaty, it talks about time to time modification of this treaty. So you can modify this treaty, but carefully noted by a duly ratified treaty concluded for the purpose between two governments. So if you want, you can modify this treaty, but it should be with the consent of both the governments, India and Pakistan. And related to this words, questions, differences, disputes, earlier we have seen an Article 9 of Indus Water Treaty. So World Bank website tells us some data related to this, that how the treaty works. On World Bank website they have given how the treaty works. First of all, questions. If there are questions, then these are handled by Permanent Indus Commission. Like recently there was a meeting. So these questions are handled by Permanent Indus Commission. After that, differences. If there are differences of opinion, then it will be resolved by neutral expert. Neutral expert will resolve the differences. And if there are disputes, then it will be referred to seven member arbitral tribunal called as Court of Arbitration. Court of Arbitration will solve the disputes. Now these three words are important: questions, differences and dispute. Now related to this, if you talk about the current differences or current disagreement, then about the construction of Kishan Ganga, which is 330 megawatt project, and Rattle, which is 850 megawatt project. So these two projects are under disagreement now. Hydroelectric power plants being built by India, these two are being built by India, and related to this resolving the disputes, if you see here, India consider it as difference while Pakistan consider it as a dispute. So India is telling that we should have neutral experts who can solve this difference, and Pakistan is saying that it is not a difference, it is a dispute, and we should appoint Court of Arbitration. So that's why the issue is going on between these two countries, Kishan Ganga and Rattle. These two projects are important. Now related to this Indus Water Treaty, first of all, we can expect a question in prelims exam, and after that there can be a detailed analysis. Because it completed 60 years, there can be a question on detailed analysis related to Indus Water Treaty in mains exam. So important rivers always asked in prelims: Indus River, tributaries of Indus River, various hydropower projects. So it is very important for prelims exam. At the same time, mains, they can ask you a specific question on Indus Water Treaty. So that's it from today's video about Indus Water Treaty. Similar kind of videos, we will appear with similar kind of videos in our next sessions. Thank you.